Greetings, Eric Bakker with a funny voice. Sorry about my mouth. I'm getting some work done on my teeth. If I sound like Robert De Niro out of Casino or the Godfather, then, but I haven't got the cigarette to go with it. You'll understand. So my apologies. I've got some inflammation on the buccal wall here just from sort of, you know, teeth work and that. We're talking about antibiotics. We're talking about the brain, in fact. How the brain gets affected by drugs like antibiotics. We're talking how the brain gets affected also by bacteria in general. You know, good bacteria, bad bacteria, yeast and stuff like that. So we're doing a series at the moment, what we do and don't know about gut health. And this is the final one called the brain. What we know, there is a seriously big influence on your gut and your brain. This has particularly come to light in the last 5 to 10 years. This is something I've known ever since I was a kid and started to eat good food and started to notice that when I eat poorly and I eat better, how different I felt. And particularly when I developed really bad candida problem myself in my 20s and overcame that after serious illness, how I noticed how I just felt better and better and better. And now I'm nearly 60 and I feel amazing because my diet is good and my lifestyle is good. So your gut has a tremendously powerful influence factor on your brain, both in terms of cognition, you know, how sharp the memory is and thinking and putting concepts together, but also in terms of the mood, how happy you feel, how sad you feel, how anxious you feel. All those things are very much tweaked and tuned and affected by the gut. So we did a previous video on antibiotics, on how they can affect you in different ways. And when you look at stuff like this online, common antibiotics may be linked to temporary mental confusion. So this again highlights the fact that when you manipulate the bacteria in the gut, you can cause really good things to happen or really bad things to happen. So this guy's basically, this was published in 2016, the American Academy of Neurology. So this wasn't just some sort of, you know, fluffy cat website. This is like a proper scientifically validated website. So what this Harvard professor here is saying basically is they did a study involving 391 patients over 70 years using a total of 54 types of antibiotics in 12 different classes. They found 47% of people involved in the study developed hallucinations or delusions, 14% had seizures, 15% had involuntary muscle twitching, 5% had complete loss of body movements. And they did ECGs on people and they detected seriously abnormal brainwave patterns. Now, this is just from antibiotics, okay? So can you imagine if you don't take antibiotics and you eat really good food all the time to build up the opposite, you know, and you take probiotics instead of anti? I could never work out the anti theory of medicine, to be honest. Why we try and be anti-health. Antibiotic means anti-health. If you're trying to get good health, why the hell would you swallow something that's anti-health? You might as well swallow plutonium or something, you know? So if you want good mental health, you obviously need to live in a situation that's low stress. There are, again, many studies have validated that people living in high-stress situations have very poor mental health, both cognitive and also emotionally. But the connection between the brain and the gut now, there's overwhelming evidence that the people with a plant-based Mediterranean-style diets tend to be happier, a lot brighter, a lot sharper, a lot smarter, a lot higher IQ than people who basically subsist on fries, Coke, you know, chicken nuggets and crap like that. As I've always maintained, eat crap, look like crap, feel like crap. So it's the bottom line, isn't it? If you want good mental health, and we know what influences mental health now from a gut sense, the answers are all there. You've got to eat well and live well. Because if you look at the flip side, unfortunately, many patients I've seen with high anxiety and depression, they don't live well, they don't eat well. And they seem to have this illusion, many people, that if they take medications like Prozac or things like that, they'll actually feel better. But I've rarely ever met anybody who takes a psychiatric medicine that feels fantastic. They usually feel half dead. So those are the people that really will benefit generally from improving their gut through eating really well all the time and also improving their lifestyle and trying to remove the factors, the stressful factors away that really cause a lot of these problems. I hope you've enjoyed this series on what we know and what we don't know about the gut. We're going to carry on in other videos. Again, sorry about my clunky mouth, but I'm getting there. Thank you all. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.